Oscar Wilde once wrote that the only thing worse than being talked about is not being talked about at all. Mike Pence's appearance at Lucas Oil Stadium would have garnered a cutaway or two during Sunday's 49er Colt game. That is until a group of 49ers players knelt during the national anthem. And that was enough for the vice president to make a swift exit and denounce the demonstration, saying, "I left today's Colts game because at POTUS, and I will not dignify any event that disrespects our soldiers, our flag, or our national anthem." Pence's exit immediately became a national story, hook, line, and sinker. And minutes later, President Trump joined in, tweeting, "I asked Vice President Pence to leave the stadium if any players kneeled, disrespecting our country." Media criticized the event as a PR stunt. And after the game, Eric Reed talked about the vice president's exit.
"With the information that I have, the last time he's been to a Colts game is 3 years ago. So this looks like a PR stunt to me. He knew our team has had the most players protest. He knew that we were probably going to do it again. And so this is what systemic oppression looks like. A man with power comes to the game, tweets a couple things out, and leaves the game with an attempt to thwart our efforts."
It may have been a PR stunt, but the administration succeeded in dictating the narrative of the story. The so-called disrespect of the flag, it's not the message of Colin Kaepernick nor anybody else. But when Pence became the story, Kaepernick's message got clouded in the distortion. By Monday, critics were still talking about it. The cost of the trip to Indianapolis and Jerry Jones' stand or be fired mandate in Dallas. Who was talking about social injustice? And the president was kicking back in the Oval Office, thinking to himself, any publicity is better than no publicity. I'm Dennis O'Donnell.